Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Today I am going to share with you a quick recipe for making butternut squash French fries. I got these pre-cut fries from Trader Joe's. You don't have to buy the pre-cut fries, but this is just a quick way to make French fries if you are in a hurry. So all you need to do is grab a pan, and I don't use oil, so I put the fries directly on the pan. It's sort of like a cookie sheet. It's a small cookie sheet, and I just put enough fries on here for me. I'm just cooking for me today, and I am going to add some seasonings. I'm in the mood for onion powder today, so I'm going to add a little bit of onion powder and just sprinkle that on top. You can put whatever kind of seasoning you want on your fries. Next, I'm going to add a little bit of a kick, so I'm going to put some crushed red pepper on there. Next, I'm going to add some garlic powder. I put garlic on just about everything, either fresh garlic or the kind you buy in the store that's already pre-cut, and garlic powder, garlic granules, whatever I can find. I love garlic. It makes everything taste good to me. Next, I'm going to add some basil. I love adding herbs to my food. It adds a depth of flavor that you wouldn't get if you didn't add it. So add some herbs to your food. Just experiment. Try whatever kind of herb you can find. They taste good. So now I'm gonna bake these bad boys, and I think I'm gonna put the oven on 425. This is the first time I'm using this oven, so I don't know how well 425 in a gas stove is gonna do, because it's been a long time since I cooked on gas. But you will have to judge based on your own oven. But you do want the oven hot so that you can make the fries crispy. Okay, here goes the baking. I'm gonna add them to the oven. I hope it turns out the way I'm thinking they're gonna turn out in this oven. So we'll see in about 15 or 20 minutes. I'll show you what they look like. Okay, so they're looking a little crispier. I think mine are gonna need another 5 minutes. Okay, so I'm gonna take these out of the oven. Can't find my pot holders yet. We're still trying to put our house back together from being remodeled, so I'm using a dish towel. Not that you cared about that, but I'm trying to close the oven and hold the camera at the same time. So I think these are crispy enough for me. Yeah, they taste good. They're sweet. They almost taste like sweet potatoes, actually. That's good. I'm gonna serve these up, and I am gonna serve them. Actually, I'm gonna dip them, and then you guys might think this is weird, but I use mustard to dip my French fries, and I always have. I used to do a mayonnaise ketchup combination, but my preference is mustard. So there are all kinds of dipping sauces that you can use to dip your fries in. Hopefully I will have time this month to share with you some dipping sauces so you can make your food taste yummy. But this is what I'm gonna have. This is good. I can't wait to eat these. Wow. They turned out better than I thought they would. I could taste the onion powder, the garlic. All right,
okay, this is the finished product. Here's my little bit of French fries. My mustard. I got some hummus here. I got a quarter of an avocado right here. About a half of an English cucumber. A little bowl of blueberries. A big thing of cherry tomatoes. And I'm going to enjoy it. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. And I hope to talk to you all soon.